rainy old day, practicing a few funky little coin tricks. Doing tricks here, doing tricks again, from Michael Rubinstein's coin magic book. I've covered a few tricks now from Michael Rubinstein's coin magic. If you check my other videos, you can see that. So today, I'm gonna get into some more of these fantastic tricks from this great book. Let's get into it. I'm gonna do them all back to back, and I'll see you after. Okay, here we have a little purse, and inside are three coins. We'll put the purse to one side. We'll take these three coins, watch carefully. One, two, three coins in the hand. If I give my hand a little shake, it goes up the arm and down into the other hand. That's a miracle. So that's one over there, and of course two over here. We'll place these two in this hand, and of course this one in this hand. The next one will go up the arm, across the shoulder, down the other arm. See, it starts over here and ends up over there. But watch again, if I take the third coin, give it a little wave, that coin disappears. It doesn't disappear, it ends up back over with the other two. Now if I take these coins from here, the three coins, give it a little wave, a little blow, and the coins will actually disappear completely. If you listen, you can hear the coins inside the purse. And that is a nice little trick. For this little piece of trickery, we require two hands, and obviously a coin, an American half dollar, 50 cent piece. We'll place that coin over here in the hand, and we'll reach out, and we have a Chinese coin. Chinese coin with a hole in the center. And over here we reach out, and we have an old English penny. Three coins. We'll take the old English penny over here, the Chinese coin, the American half dollar, all going in the left hand. A little shake, and one of the coins travels to my right hand. It is, in fact, the English penny. If you watch again, we'll close the hands around the coin, and one coin will actually travel to my right hand. It is, in fact, American half in my left hand, and of course the Chinese and the English penny in my right. Now watch this last coin. The American half will slowly travel across, just like in there. Not very impressive, not very magical. But if I take the American half over here, take these two coins, cover them up with this playing card, a coaster, mobile phone, even the ear of a small dog can be used. We'll place the coin inside the hand, a little rub and a wave, and the coin will actually end up to join the other two. It can be in the spectator's hand, or under a card. And that, I believe, is a mirror. Good old stain. Now this one's a little bit mental. It requires three coins. Obviously, we're doing coin magic. And I have them in my pocket over here. So three coins are used. Watch, that's one, two, three coins. Watch the first coin. Three here, one travels to over there. That's the first coin. Now don't blink, because you will miss it. It travels to over here. Two over here, one over there. Watch the next one go up and travel across. That's coin number two. So we have three coins in total. Two coins have gone across. The third one is gonna go with a bit more finesse. I'm gonna throw it in the air, goes around the back, and ends up in the head. And that is three coins. One at a time to the other hand. That is mental. So, I hope you enjoyed them three fantastic effects there. Obviously, I need to master them and perfect them and get them down. All of the effects I've learned so far out of this book are really, really good, blowing me away. Rather than spending hundreds of pounds on gimmick coins, this book is a no-brainer. 150% definitely get it. And the first effect that you saw is called long-term, short-term. Now that's due to the pattern that he uses, which I didn't use. All these effects here are actually from chapter 12. Long-term, short-term. If you got it, look it up. Fantastic. The second one was actually called CSB, coins across. And that's on page 208, chapter 12. The third one being my favorite, and I'm definitely gonna be using that trick. I'm gonna master it to the point it's perfect. And that was called Retrofly, which is fantastic, where you can show the coin literally visibly jump from one hand to the other and you end clean. Love it. That is on page 202, chapter 12 also. So look them up if you've got the book. If you haven't got the book, what are you waiting for? So there you have it. Some fantastic effects for Michael Rubinstein's coin magic. And also last week I covered some tricks from Bruce Servan, the Servan file. I posted that one on Friday and there's some really nice effects out of that book. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I'm not gonna go on about how you should subscribe, leave a comment, smash that like button, but also pressing the notification bell so you don't miss any of the videos. I'm not gonna do all that. Have fun, see you next time. Peace, and keep the magic real.